Hello kitchen queens and kings, welcome to my channel Gina in the kitchen. If you like this video, please hit the like button, share it with your friends and family, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Now let's quickly move on to today's recipe. To make jeera onion rice, I have taken 1 glass basmati rice, and first of all we need to wash these rice. Making jeera onion rice is very simple. We just need to take care of few simple steps so the rice does not get sticky and each and every grain is separated. So to know all the tricks to make perfect jeera onion rice in pressure cooker, watch this video till the end. So the first thing we need to take care is we need to wash our rice thoroughly. As you can see right now, the water of rice in which I'm washing the rice is not clear. It's not transparent. The water has extra starch in it, so we need to wash our rice till the water becomes clear. So wash your rice at least 3-4 times with water. And now after washing our rice 3-4 times, we can see the water is almost clear. It's transparent. We can see rice in the bowl. So that means they are ready to cook. Let's discard this water and now we need to soak our rice for 20 to 25 minutes. As we have taken 1 glass of rice, so I'm taking 1 glass plus 1/4 glass of water, and this will be the perfect measurement to get our rice not sticky. So if you are using measuring cups or any bowl, for each bowl take 1 plus 1/4 cup water. To make perfect jeera onion rice, we need to take care of the ratio of water and rice properly. And now we will keep these rice aside for minimum 20 to 25 minutes. And it's been 25 minutes and our rice are ready to cook. So let's move on to the gas burner. And here I have kept a pressure cooker on high flame and added 3 tablespoons of clarified butter in it. Or you can use oil if you want to. And our ghee or clarified butter is hot, so I'm adding 1.5 teaspoon jeera or cumin seeds, 2 bay leaves, 1 black cardamom. We will break the cardamom from top of it so that it can spread its aroma properly. 1/2 teaspoon whole black pepper and 3 to 4 cloves. And now we are going to add onions in the pressure cooker. So here I have taken 2 medium sized onions cut into thin slices, and you can skip adding onions if you want to make plain jeera rice. Let's mix all the things, and we don't need to cook the onions for so long. We don't want them to change their color or to get brown, so we will just cook them for 1 to 2 minutes on high flame. And after cooking the onions for just 1 to 2 minutes, I am adding 1.5 teaspoon salt. You can adjust the quantity of salt according to your taste. And now we will also add our rice with water in pressure cooker. Water we have already measured while soaking the rice. Just mix it once and we will close the lid of pressure cooker. And we will let it cook till it get one whistle on high flame. Our pressure cooker gave one whistle and I turned off the flame. And immediately we need to release the pressure from cooker. So just take the help of a spatula like this and release all the pressure. Pressure is released, so let's open our cooker. And we just need to mix our rice once with light hands. And now we will close the lid again. Do not turn on the flame, just keep it closed and leave it for 10 minutes. As when we will close the lid, it will create some heat because rice are hot. In that heat, our rice will get properly cooked. Each grain will get separate from each other. And our onions and masala which we have added in rice will get mixed with the rice properly. So it's been 10 minutes. Let's open our pressure cooker. Add little bit coriander leaves. And you can see our rice are perfectly ready. Perfectly cooked. They are not sticky at all. Each and every grain is separated from each other. and they are ready to serve hot. So how did you find this recipe and all the tricks? Please let me know in the comment sections. I love your comments. And if you are new to my channel and you haven't subscribed it yet, please do it right now. Press the bell icon too so that you can get notifications whenever I upload a new video or a new recipe. So that's it for today. We will catch up again really soon.